grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us first call to mind our sins, so as to prepare ourselves and to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you have brought us the treasure of the love of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus Christ, by your death you have won for us the treasure of forgiveness and life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have left us the Eucharist, the treasure of your presence and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
God said, ask something of me, and not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding mind to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours? The Lord was pleased that Solomon made his request. So God said to him, because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right. I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you there will come no one to equal you. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides it again. And out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys the field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great value, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets, what is bad they throw away. Thus, it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into a fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things?" They answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old." The Gospel of the Lord. Good afternoon, everyone. In today's Gospel, Jesus continued his teaching about the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God. And it would be fair to assume that Jesus' disciples were a bit disappointed. After all, the Jews were expecting a king, a revolutionary leader, a liberator with great military might. Instead, Jesus uses simple tales to talk about God's kingdom, which back then, these stories were very clear and understood by everyone. Even today, our expectations of God's vision may not fit our own reality because we are not ready to accept Him and to do His will. In Luke chapter 17, verse 21, Jesus said, "The kingdom of God is in your midst." In other words, when Jesus speaks of the kingdom, it's not in the next life. The parables can open our eyes and ears to God's unexpected and surprising ways. The first two parables reveal to us that there is nothing in the world more important and valuable than the kingdom of God. The kingdom is the reign of God in our hearts, in our lives, in our homes, in our society, and in our world. It is accepting Jesus as our God and Savior, putting our faith in God and doing His will. Jesus teaches us that the kingdom is something of extraordinary value, like a hidden treasure or a costly pearl. And possessing this priceless treasure calls for a total commitment to preserve it. A treasure is something that we stumble upon. A finder does nothing to deserve it. It means that someone else has done the work for the finder. It is a gift. On the other hand, the merchant has been searching for this pearl. He knows that it exists and recognizes it once he sees it. Brothers and sisters, this is how God works in our lives. Saul has this sudden encounter with God where he reveals himself to them and immediately transforms their lives. Others are like the pearl seekers, studying the scriptures, attending retreats, always looking and trying their best to do God's will. And this search may go on for years until one day God revealed himself to them. In both cases, the actions of the finder and the seeker is decisive. They are not willing to give up everything, holding back nothing, with great joy to possess this valuable treasure of pearl. We should consider this question: what are we giving up? After all, the kingdom of heaven is not about material possessions, wealth, social status, degrees, prestige, worldly pressures. But like the finder and the seeker, we may have to endure, suffer great sacrifices without looking back. The world offers us many distractions, and in essence, there's nothing wrong with them, except when these false treasures become more important than God in our lives, we are no longer on the right path. As a result, our personal relationship with God is put on a shelf, collecting dust, or locked away, never to be seen in a treasure box. One of the best examples of God's blessings is Solomon. He surrendered himself to God's will, and he not only received wisdom, but also much more. In the third parable, the dragnet catches the good and the bad fish. The catch is sorted out later ashore, with the good fish going to the market and the unacceptable, the non-edible fish being thrown away. The church and the entire world is a mixture, blend of all kinds of people, good and bad, useful and useless, saints and sinners. Like the wheat among the wheat, the parable of last Sunday, it is a warning against premature judgment, and a warning that judgment will come. We must be more welcoming, tolerant, compassionate, and understanding of those who seem not to meet the requirements of the gospel and the kingdom. Let us remember that most of us have been bad fish in God's ocean more than once, and God has shown us his mercy. Jesus instructs us to embrace God's vision, to seek out the good everywhere, even in the most unlikely places. Let us remember, while we are here on earth, the kingdom is within the reach of all of us who try to do God's will. Following the ordinary vocation of life and enjoying happiness and peace within the framework of God's commandments. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, we must take care of our treasure, which is our personal relationship with Jesus Christ. It is our Lord, our Savior, who attends to our needs every day with compassion and love.
To us as church is to pray for everyone and all, that they may discover the treasure of our faith.
For all Christians, that they may all hear their faith and their life in Christ and keep living up to their convictions, let us pray to the Lord. For people everywhere, that they may open their eyes and their hearts to the good news of Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord. For the leaders of nations, that as they work for prosperity and progress, they may not lose sight of what is essential, that is, people and the deepest human values, let us pray to the Lord. For those who are rich in possessions and talents, that they may put their gifts and goods at the service of people, let us pray to the Lord. For the sick and the poor among us, that they may discover in the loving care of people something of the goodness of God Himself, let us pray to the Lord. For our young people, that their parents and the church may give on to them their living faith and the spirit to serve God and all people as well, let us pray to the Lord. For us gathered here, may each of us be grateful for the gift of the Eucharist and experience with faith and love in this encounter with our Lord Jesus in Holy Communion, let us pray to the Lord. For the intention we hold in the silence of our heart, let us pray to the Lord. For the intention of this Mass, Jose de Arimatea Gonzalez, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. This is my body, which will be given up for you. He said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant,
which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. This way
promise I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold, the pearl of the great price. Behold, him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. Any questions, Deacon?
One, just to remind everybody that this Mass is being suspended temporarily. So if you come next week at 1 o'clock, it's going to be in Spanish.
like I said at the beginning of the Mass, I'm now the vocations director for our diocese, which means I'm entrusted with the care of the future of the priesthood in our diocese, both our seminarians and recruiting new seminarians. I want to thank you for the prayers that you have offered for vocations. This year it's been particularly fruitful and effective. We've accepted 7 new seminarians for our diocese this year. So 7 good, healthy, holy, handsome young men who, for whatever reason, have encountered that treasure and that pearl of great price, and are choosing in the midst of everything we have going on in our world right now, are choosing to pursue the Lord and to place their lives in His hands. So thank you so much for your ongoing prayers for vocations. Keep it up. I don't want just 7 new seminarians. I want to get up to like 30, 40 guys. So the more you pray, the more effective it is for us. I know of my deep gratitude for all that you do to help support and pray for vocations. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace.